إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن نبينا محمد عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، إن شاء الله my voice is not that good today. Been having flu for 5 days, so إن شاء الله I will try my best إن شاء الله. Okay. Before we go to the lesson, we normally ask questions from the previous lessons, so to know whether you are with me or not. So inshallah we take a few questions from the last lesson that we took, and so what is the meaning of basira, Yusuf? قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة.
This means with knowledge.
Knowledge. بارك الله فيك. ما شاء الله. So بصيرة is knowledge. On the battle of Khaybar, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Tomorrow I will give the flag to someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him, and Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam also love him." Who was that? Ismail. Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. ما شاء الله. لأعطين الراية غدا إلى رجل. وعليكم السلام. Tomorrow I will give the flag to a man who loves Allah and the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and Allah and the Messenger they love him. That was Ali bin Abi Talib رضي الله تعالى عنه. Then the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, Ali, he gave him a commandment or an order. What was that, Ihsan?
That you call the people mm-hmm. to Islam, mm-hmm. And if they refuse, then offer them to pay jizya. Mm-hmm. And if they refuse, then fight them.
Yeah, mashallah. Yeah, that is good. Okay. Okay, Sajid, when the Messenger ﷺ dispatched Mu'adh bin Jabal رضي الله عنه to Yemen, he told him something. What did he say to him?
He told the people of Yemen, I believe they're Christians. Mm-hmm. He told them, tell them Tawheed first, mm-hmm. so Basira,
okay.
knowledge. Mm-hmm. He starts with Tawheed, believing in oneness of Allah. Then if, when they accept, then you teach them the Salah. Mm-hmm. And after the Salah, you teach them the Zakat. Mm-hmm. But the Zakat they pay mm-hmm. is what they have. So mm-hmm. it's not what the Muslims already have. Okay. What they pay, mm-hmm. they pay that a bit less.
Okay.
Because they need to.
They pay, when you are collecting the charity, do not sort out all the best?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Those who are the best.
Okay. Okay. And then he said to him, he warned against something.
He warned.
Did he say like don't oppress them because then they could do all the oppressing?
Yeah, yeah, mashallah, mashallah. So inshallah ta'ala, why do I have to ask you these questions? Because I want to know if you are with me or your body is present and your mind is somewhere else. Maybe it's in a Tesco or at Lidl or shopping. With your wife, if you are married, otherwise by yourself, inshallah. So we did not finish the last lesson. فيه مسائل, we did not finish them. So which number did we stop?
Oh, he said, Muhammad said, to Malik and Jabal make a shield for the one who does injustice yeah. to people, so they will make the wall on you and you will suffer.
Yeah, that's true. So which Masail did we stop? Hassan?
The ugliness of shirk, sorry, the of the signs of the beauty of Tawheed, it's being free from any blasphemy towards Allah.
Okay. So which number, you don't remember the number?
We were number four.
Number four?
No.
Number six.
We done much more than that.
Hmm?
We done, I think we're on, we done 14, I remember we done 14. So probably we done 15. Beware of the supplication of the oppressed, we done 16. There's no barrier between the oppressed and Allah. We done 17. I think we're on the 18.
18, yeah?
18, the afflictions, hardship, hunger, and epidemic suffered by the head of all prophets. Yeah, we didn't do this one.
Okay. Okay, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله عليه وسلم. الثامنة عشر number 18 من أدلة التوحيد the دليل of the توحيد ما جرى على سيد المرسلين وذهب into the head of the messengers who is محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وسادات الأولياء and the leaders of the أولياء من المشقة from hardship والجوع hunger والوباء and illnesses. So, even the Messenger was chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yet he has to go through difficulties, hardship, hunger, poverty, all sorts of trial. He faces sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and those who were with him. And the Messenger died and left this world without putting a brick on top of another brick. What does that mean? That means he did not have a house to live in. He had small huts where his wives were staying. If he wanted, he could build golden houses. But his objective was not to run after the world. He could have everything he wanted, but he did not want it because when Umar radiallahu anhu saw the Messenger of Sallam is living on Hasir. Hasir is a mat which had some lines on it. It had strips on it. And those lines were on the body of the Messenger of Sallam. Then Umar started crying. He said, you are in this situation. You don't have anything, O Messenger of Allah. While the kings of Persia and Roman have got everything. Then the Messenger said to him, Mahlan ya Umar, or stop Umar, are you not happy that this world is for them and we have Akhirah? Subhanallah. So that doesn't mean that we cannot save money, we cannot work. No, we can go to work, we can have nice cars, we can have beautiful houses, we can enjoy our lives, but with Iman. But anything that damages your iman, you have to throw it out. Because iman is the most important thing that we have in our life. التاسعة عشر number 19 قوله لأعطين الراية I will give the flag إلى آخره to the end علم من علام النبوة is a sign of the prophethood of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he mentioned something that will happen tomorrow and it happened exactly the same way that the Messenger mentioned. العشرون تفله في عينيه علم من علامي أيضا. Spitting in the eyes of Ali was also one of the signs of the prophethood of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because when he's back into the eyes of Ali, what happened? Ali was healed Israeli. Subhanallah. Because the spitting of the Messenger of Allah has a barakah. That's why when one of the Persian people came to the Messenger of Allah and the Sahaba, he said, I have seen the kings and I have seen all the leaders of the world. I have never seen people the way that they love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I have never seen it. He said, "Idha tamakhadha, if he spits out, they fight over his spit. They won't collect it because it has barakah. If he shaves his hair, they collect it. If the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam that hijama and blood comes from his head, they will fight over who will take that blood." And you remember that Sahabi, I think he was Zubair ibn Awam radiallahu anhu. The Messenger told him, take this blood. After the hijama was done to the Messenger, take the blood and bury it somewhere far. And what did he do? He took the blood. When he walked for a mile, he just looked sideways. If someone was after him, then he started. He drank all the blood. He drank it. Because he wants this blood to be in his body. Because it's the blood of the Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the way they love the Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanallah. And the Messenger, when he came back, he said, what have you done to the blood? He just became silent. He said, I know what you have done, but you should have done so. He said, by Allah, I done it. And I done it out of love for you. And the Messenger of Allah just kept quiet. So this is the way they used to love the Messenger of Allah. But the question is, can we do something else today to this kind of love? No. That was only special for the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If he spits, they take his back, his blood, his hair, everything. But can you do that to a beer sap or somewhere else? No. No one else. That's only for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And even the female companions of the Messenger of Allah sallam, when the Messenger of Allah sleeps, his sweating, they used to put into perfumes. Because they said, by Allah, his sweating is more, subhanallah, stronger, has strong fragrance than the other one. Yeah, subhanallah. So that is special for him, alayhi salatu wa salam. And we also understand Al-Hadiyyat wal-Ishroon number 21, Fadilatu Ali radiallahu anhu. The virtues of Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu bin Abi Talib is, mashallah, has a, he is top man in Islam radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Because number one is the cousin and the relative of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say to him, أَلَا تَرْضَى أَن تَكُونَ مِنِّي مِنْ مَنْزِلَةِ هَارُونَ مِنْ مُوسَى. O Ali, are you not happy that you be to me like Harun was to Musa عليه السلام. غير أن لا نبي بعدي. Even though there is no prophet after me. So Ali رضي الله عنه, why did the Messenger said to him, say to that to him? Because one day the Messenger and the Sahaba, they went out for jihad, and the Messenger left Ali to be in control of Medina. So Ali, he said to the Messenger, what happened, O Messenger of Allah? You know that I'm a warrior. I'm a fighter. Why do you leave me with women and children? Then the messenger said to him, "O Ali, are you not happy that you be to me like Harun was to Musa, even though there is no prophet after me, sallallahu alaihi wasallam?" But the Shia, may Allah guide them, they made like 30,000, can you believe? 30,000 hadith about the virtues of Ali, radiallahu anhu. They just made up. Till they turn Ali into an idol. Now they like the Christians, Allah sent Isa to them to guide them. Then they had so extreme, they went extreme into Isa alayhi salam, and they made him divine. They made him to be divine, a God, or the Son of God, something like that. Now the Shia, in the same way, they are saying, if you read their books, they are saying, on the Day of Judgment, the key of the Jannah will be in the hands of Ali, and the key of the Hellfire will be in the hands of Ali, and he will take the Jannah to whomever he wants, and he will send it to the Hellfire to whomever he wants. Subhanallah. And some of them are openly saying, Ali is our Lord and Savior, is Allah. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. That is, subhanallah. Even the Messenger said, "La tadruni kama adarati Nasara ibn Maryam, innama ana Abdullahi wa Rasul." Don't be extreme into me like the Christians did to Isa. I am simply the Messenger and the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. So, now they are saying Ali has created the moon, the stars, the sun, the fish, the bee, everything, the vegetation. Everything that you come across was made by Ali radiallahu anhu, and his children, Hassan and Hussein, and Fatima radiallahu anha. They also now believe that there is a special Quran, which we don't have it today. They call it Mushaf Fatima. The Quran of Fatima, radiallahu anhu. There is no Quran of Fatima. This Quran was given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is it. So we have to be very careful about those people. They are very, very dangerous. They took the people from subhanallah, tawheed, into shirk. الثانية والعشرون number 22 فضل الصحابة في دوكهم تلك الليلة. The virtues of the Sahaba about their debating that on in that night was shughulihim an bisharat al-fath, and they were busy about the conquest of fath. They instead of focusing on that, they were talking about who will be given the flag tomorrow. الثالث والعشرون number 23 الإيمان بالقدر لحصولها لمن لم يسع لها ومنعها عمن سعى. الإيمان بالقدر, believing in the قدر, in the destiny, لحصولها لمن لم يسعى لها. It will be given to anyone who works for it, and it will be forbidden from anyone who doesn't work for it. So that we also have to believe the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that happens in the world is only happening because of Allah's will. No one else is there. الرابعة والعشرون number 24 الأدب في قوله على رسلك. The Messenger, when he was sending Ali, he said to him, "Ala rislika, And don't be rushed, just walk slowly. Al-Khamis 25, الدعوة إلى الإسلام قبل القتال. Before fighting, you have to invite the people to Islam. Because the objective of the fighting is not to force the people into belief. The objective of the fighting is to remove those who are standing between Islam and the people. So before you fight them, you give them da'wah. If they accept Islam, then there's no fighting. They are already your brothers and sisters. Why you fight? If they don't listen, then that will come. السادسة والعشرون number 26 أنه مشروع لمن دعوا قبل ذلك وقوتلوا لمن دعوا قبل ذلك وقوتلوا so it's permissible دعوة to be given before fighting يعني. السابعة والعشرون number 27 الدعوة بالحكمة لقوله أخبرهم بما يجب عليهم. The da'wah is based on wisdom. When the messenger was sent, Mu'ad, he said to him, أخبرهم بما يجب عليهم. Tell them what Allah has made obligatory upon them. So this is the wisdom. The da'wah without wisdom will not have any fruits. But it will be to the contrary, the people will run away from your da'wah. It must be based on wisdom. الثامنة والعشرون number 28 المعرفة بحق الله في الإسلام. The knowledge of the rights of Allah in Islam. التاسعة والعشرون number 29 ثواب من اهتدى على يديه رجل واحد. سبحان الله, the reward and the ajr that a man gets if only one person is guided through your da'wah. So now, how many are sitting here? If you give da'wah even to a Muslim, to a non-Muslim, and they are guided, mashallah, you will get da'wah is not easy. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِمَنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So if you invite the people to what you know, some people may say, you know, I don't have knowledge, so how can I invite? No, what do you know? You know Tawheed? Just call the Tawheed. You know the Salah? Call the Salah. So inshallah ta'ala give da'wah. And what did the messenger said to him when he was sending Ali, that if one person is guided through your da'wah, that is better for you than the red camels. Because the Arabs in those days, they had a love of red camels. It's like today. Like those expensive things. One person is better, wallahi, to guide to the right path. Especially if you have siblings like your brother, like your sister, like your cousins, your nephews, your family. You have to try to give them da'wah. The proper aqidah. Aqidah always number one. Number 30, number 30. Al-Hilifu al-Futiya. Futiya means is asking questions. So swearing on. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said, by Allah. When he was telling Ali, what did he say? By Allah. So when someone is giving fatwa or a verdict about something, it's permissible. He can swear it to emphasize it. Babu tafsir al-tawheed wa shahadati an la ilaha illallah. This is the chapter of Tafsir al-Tawheed.
I had a question. Point number 19.
Number 19.
It says the sign of one of the signs of prophethood is I will give the flag and until the end of the hadith.
Yeah.
How, in what way is it because of a prediction? Like, how is it a sign of prophethood? I don't understand.
Ali, he mentioned that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu loves Allah, okay, and Allah and the Messenger love him, and that it was it came to everyone later on, apparent to everyone, that was a sign of prophethood. Is that clear now? That's what the Sheikh said. Tafsir al-Tawhidi, the tafsir. The meaning of Tawheed. وَشَهَادَةِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And the shahada of لا إله إلا الله. This chapter is so important as well. قوله تعالى أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَى رَبِّهِمُ الْوَسِيلَةِ أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ, those they are يَدْعُونَ, calling upon them, yeah, the Jewish were calling upon Uzair, the Christians were calling upon Isa alayhi salam, and the mushrikeen, their idols. Allah said, يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمُ الْوَسِيلَةِ. Those you are calling and begging them 24/7, they themselves looking for a way, الْوَسِيلَةِ is a way to read something. They are looking for a way, أَيِّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ, which one of them is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now when the idol worshippers were asked, why do you worship the idols? They had inside the Kaaba, how many they had? 360 idols. When the messengers of Allah captured Mecca from the idol worshippers, and when they went into the Haram, they found out they had inside the Kaaba 360 idols. Each tribe had its own idol. Subhanallah. That means these people, they did not deny the existence of Allah. They believed there was Allah. And Allah is the creator of everything. Allah is the one who brings down the rain. Allah is the one. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, they believe it. But when they were asked, why are you worshiping these idols, they say, لَيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لَيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. We are not worshiping them except that they take us closer to Allah. Like some of the Muslims of today say it. You know, I cannot beg Allah, I cannot call, invoke Allah, supplicate to Allah directly. I need to go through Pir Sahab, to Sheikh Abdul Qadir, Sayyid Al Badawi, Hussein, Zainab. I need someone who is. And one of them will say one day, you know, when you are supplicating to Allah, you have to supplicate to Allah with a tongue that doesn't make any sin. So I cannot see how the shaitan is playing tricks on them. So I am reaching out to Allah, going through that. Who told you this, Sheikh who passed away long time ago? His tongue never sinned. Who told you? Who told you that they never sin. Subhanallah, this is sheer ignorance, this is big jahl. So they say, we cannot supplicate, we have a lot of sins, you know, we are bad people, we do so many mistakes, or we have, yeah, my iman is not that strong, so I need someone to go through to Allah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Allah's door is open all the time. Allah said in the Quran, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if my servants ask you about me, this is what Allah is saying. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ, tell them I'm so close to them. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةِ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ, and I accept the supplication of the one who invokes me. Allahu Akbar. So, why do you need to go through someone else? To go to Allah through somebody else, you don't need it. So, let me clarify something now. How many messengers were sent before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who were so close to Allah? So many. Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, Yahya, Zakaria. Did our Prophet ever said in his life, oh, Ya Ibrahim, help me, Ya Isa, Ya Musa, I'm going through, I'm reaching out to Allah through Ibrahim, through Musa, through... Did he say no? He was calling to Allah directly. Subhanallah. So Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ, indeed those, they are يَدْعُونَ, supplicating, invoking, begging, يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمُ الْوَسِيلَةِ, they themselves looking for wasila, they are a way of reaching out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَب, who is more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, you have, in Islam, you need to call to Allah directly. No one is between you and Allah. Subhanallah. This is the understanding of the mushrikeen. They used to say, we are not worshiping with idols. We know they don't have any benefits. They cannot answer our calls. We know them. But they are there. We go to them, so we can reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how did shirk start on the earth. It started at the time of Nuh alayhi salam. There were some righteous men, and when they died, Shaitan came to their children, and he said, you know, why can't you worship Allah like those men?
Nuh, yeah.
So, what did they do? They made statues of?
Righteous men.
Of the righteous people. And they put them inside the masjid. But they did not worship them. They used to say, when we see these pictures, we remember their ibadah, and then we increase our. That generation left. What happened? Iblis came to the next generation. He said, these are the ones. Your forefathers were worshipping these idols. And then they started having idols there. Subhanallah. That's what Imam Bukhari said in his kitab. So, we have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly without a barrier between, there's no barrier between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah. And Allah said, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ, or remember Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ibrahim said to his dad, وَقَوْمِهِ, and to his people. إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ I'm free from what you are worshipping. I got nothing to do with your idols. إِلَّا الَّذِي فَضَرَنِي Accepted the one that created me. Who is that created him? Allah. See? Ibrahim alayhi salam. How he destroyed the religion of his father and his people. وَإِذْ قَالَ لِإِبْرَاهِيمُ وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ Remember when Ibrahim said لِأَبِيهِ to his dad وَقَوْمِهِ and his people إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ I'm free from what you are worshipping. From I got nothing to do with him. إِلَّا الَّذِي فَضَرَنِي Except the one that created me. Allahu Akbar. In another ayah, Ibrahim alayhi salam said, he, with a respect to his dad, because you have to respect your dad, he said, يَا أَبَتِي لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يُبْصِرُ لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا Why do you worship something that doesn't see, doesn't hear, and doesn't suffice you from anything? يَا أَبَتِ إِنِّي قَدْ جَاءَنِي مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَمْ يَأْتِكَ Oh, Dad, I have the knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which you don't have it. فَاتَّبِعْنِي أَهْدِكَ صِرَاطًا سَوِيًّا Follow me, I will guide you to the right path. يَا أَبَتِ لَا تَعْبُدُ الشَّيْطَانِ Oh, my Dad, do not worship the shaytan. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ الرَّحْمَانِ عَصِيًّا Indeed, Satan was disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَبَتِ إِنِّي أَخَافُ أَنْ يَمَسَّكَ عَذَابٌ مِنَ الرَّحْمَانِ فَتَكُونَ لِلشَّيْطَانِ وَلِيًّا Oh my dad, I fear that hellfire will touch you by following the shaytan. So he was telling his dad not to worship idols. And all the time he was saying, my dad, my dad, my dad. Respect him. And his dad's name was Azr. Then his dad said to him, what did he say to him? He said to him, Subhanallah, are you telling me to abandon my God, my wahjurni maliyan. Leave me alone. Otherwise something bad is going to happen to you. Salamun alayka sa'astaghfiru laka rabbi innahu kana bi hafiya. He said, peace be upon you, oh my dad. I will leave you. Because he did his obligation. So there's no compromise between you and your dad, even if your dad tells you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, your dad will never tell you now to worship idols or something like that. But maybe sometimes they say to you, go to that beer, sabrara. Maybe. Or what about if they tell you to shave your beard? No. It's the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. Don't go to the masjid. If you go to the masjid, you will become extremist. Will you accept that? No. Go to the masjid. This is the subhanallah, an honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you will respect your dad, your mom. You will be humble and kind to them. But if they tell you to disobey, you will never accept it. وقوله اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله اتخذوا they made أحبارهم their scholars أحبار جمع حبر أو حبر both of them are right أحبار What is habar? What does that mean? Scholar. Scholars. Mufrad is habar or ahbarahum. So Allah said, ittakhadu ahbarahum. They made their scholars. Wa ruhbanahum. And their religious leaders. Ruhban is jam'u rahib. Rahib is the one who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did they make? Arbaban min dunillah. They made them lords other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when this verse was sent down to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Adiy ibn Hatim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And before he accepted Islam, he was a Christian. He said, O Messenger of Allah, we did not take our scholars and our worshippers as a Lord. Then the Messenger said to him, did they not make the halal haram and the haram stuff halal? He said, yes. Then the Messenger said to him, فَتِلْكَ عِبَادَتُهُمْ. That is how you worship them. So if the scholars and the religious leaders, they make a law which is, subhanallah, equal or like the law of Allah, if you obey them, what do you take them? To be your Lord, subhanallah. So that is not allowed in Islam. وَقَوْلِهِ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ of the people مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا. Some who will take other than Allah أَنْدَادًا, something which is equal to Allah. They will take something which is equal to Allah. There is nothing equal to Allah, but they made it like something equal to Allah. So Allah said, يُحِبُّونَهُمْ, which they love, كُحُبِّ اللَّهِ, like the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. That one is not allowed completely.
Just a question on obeying the scholars and taking them as lords besides Allah. I just wanted to be more clarifying this. If a scholar comes, for example, and he says interest is halal for you, and then the people start doing that based on what this scholar said, and then when you tell them, oh no no, Allah said it's haram, and Allah said he wages war against interest, riba, and then someone says, but Sheikh, this guy said, that no, no, this under my circumstances is halal. Is he worshipping the scholar?
Of course he is, because look, making something halal or haram only belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No one else can say this is halal and this is haram except Allah and His Messenger. We have seen now, even if you go to the YouTube blend of them, you say someone who is, he has the knowledge, he's a scholar, but he's shaitan. Even I have seen one guy saying, zina is okay, there's no problem. As long as the boy and the girl are happy, as long as they agree, no problem. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir. So someone will legalize the alcohol, some will legalize riba, some will legalize zina, someone will legalize everything they want, everything they do it now. Subhanallah. So they will take as God or as a Lord if you obey them, if they say something which Allah made haram, halal. Or if they make something which Allah made it haram to be halal. Subhanallah.
There's some leaders today make haram, halal, and haram, haram. sheikh who are with them, they don't say nothing to them. They say that they speak to him privately, but if that leader does it publicly, shouldn't the sheikh or someone with knowledge say to them publicly what you're doing wrong, like Musa alayhi salam to Fir'aun, for example?
Yes, see, the Muslim scholar must be very brave. What did the Messenger of Allah say? He said, "Afdalu, shahidun, afdalu shahidin, rajulun qama." The best martyr is someone who stands up to a tyrant leader, and who says to him, "What you are doing is wrong." What can he do? He can kill you. So if you die, you die for the sake of Allah. What are you going to lose? Nothing. See what happened in Tunisia now. In Tunisia, there was a man, his name was Habib Bourguiba. Ramadan, it was Ramadan time, Ramadan came. And he said live on TV. He said he had a bottle of water. He said, no one should fast because fasting will not help us develop our country. Because if the workers are fasting, they cannot go to work. So he said, and I will start. He opened a bottle of water, started drinking live on TV. And there was, mashallah, big scholar, Dahir ibn Ashur, rahimahullah ta'ala. Dahir ibn Ashur, rahimahullah ta'ala. He has a tafsir, subhanallah, big alim, mashallah. He said, Sadaqallahu wa kadaba al-Bourguiba in front of the TV. He bring him to be his witness. Then he said, Allah has said the truth, we all fast, and Bourguiba lied. And he did not even kill him. Because when he looked at Imam Dahir ibn Ashur, he just became like chicken. He started shaking. So if you are a true scholar, and this shaitan, this Dawood is saying that, you have to have the courage of saying what you are saying is haram. Nobody should listen to you. And whatever the consequences, you will go back to Allah, whether you like it or not.
Sheikh, I've heard in the tafsir of Sa'di that he says that a Tawood is man hakama bi ghayri ma anzal Allah, the one who rules by other than what Allah.
We mentioned that one so many times.
So is it obligatory to obey someone who is a tawhud, or does a person, is it obligatory for the person to reject and disobey the tawhud?
See, the Messenger said, لا ضاعت بمخلوق في معصية الخالق. What does that mean? لا ضاعت لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. There is no obedience to the disobedience of Allah. So if someone calls you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will not obey him. That's it. وفي الصحيح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من قال لا إله إلا الله, whoever says لا إله إلا الله وكفر بما يعبد من دون الله. This is the condition. وكفر بما يعبد من دون الله and disbelieves anything that is taken as a god other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, حرم ماله ودمه, his wealth and his blood is protected, وحسابه على الله عز وجل, and his accountability will be on Allah on the day of judgment. So we need anyway like Dahir ibn Ashur rahimahullah ta'ala. He did not even imprison him, he did not kill him. And the people, they up to this day they have a big respect for that Imam, because he did not sell out his religion, he did not sell out his deen. But nowadays we have someone will say hijab is not from Islam, it's a Turkish culture, it's Arabian culture. What is this nonsense? Someone will say riba is halal, someone else will say zina is halal, someone dancing is halal, free mixing is halal. So just to make this the waqid happy, subhanallah.
Sheikh, regarding a question regarding the scholar who supports and stands along a ruler who rules by other than what Allah revealed, I found in a statement of Ibn Taymiyyah, I just want you to clarify a little bit more regarding what's the stance of this kind of scholar, where Ibn Taymiyyah said, مَتَ تَرَكَ الْعَالِمُ مَا عَلِمَ وَاتَّبَعَ الْحَاكِمُ المخالف لكتاب الله وسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان هذا العالم كافرا مرتدا يستحق العقوبة في الدنيا والآخرة. That whenever a scholar leaves what he has learned from his knowledge and follows a ruler who rules,
no, I've seen that what Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala said, and Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he was, mashallah, when the Tatars, you know, the Mongolians were overrunning the whole Muslim world, and even scholars were running away, he was the only man who faced them. And he said, they are human beings, we can defeat them, we have to stand firm, we should not flee from our houses, we should not flee from our towns, we should not flee from our masajid, we have to defend our lands. And then he said, by Allah, إِنَّكُمْ لَمَنْصُورُونَ, I swear by the name of Allah that you will win. And all the scholars, they came back, they follow him, and the Mongolians and the Tatars were defeated. So if a scholar, who seems to be a scholar, he got the knowledge, but he follows the Dawud, he will just be like another Dawud.
So he is a disbeliever.
He is a big shaitan. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan. So inshallah we stop there. And jazakumullah khair. Next week we will start from there inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Yeah, inshallah.
Yeah, inshallah.
Yeah, inshallah.
Allah.